Hey guys, it's Alicia, and today we're going to show you how to make your WordPress website accessible. The more accessible your site is, the more people can use it. When a site is less accessible, or when accessibility isn't prioritized, a portion of your audience is deterred or completely barred from getting all the information your site has to offer. In this video, we'll discuss how to make a WordPress site accessible and how to test a site's accessibility. Before we get too far, I want to let you know that there will be links to more resources in the video's description. And remember, subscribe and ring that bell to get notifications for future helpful content. So, let's get started. All images on your site need to be accessible to all users. Given that not all users can see images, some may use assistive technology to understand visual elements, and your site should therefore be ready to work with that technology. Alternative text is a written description that you attach to an image. Screen readers will read that description aloud to any guest who may not see the image. Alternative text should be used for any images that provide helpful information on the page. This includes everything from photos to icons to infographics. The only exception is if an image is considered purely decorative. Background images, dividers, or images that show text presented on the page itself won't necessarily need alternative text. When writing your alt text, remember not to describe the image as it is. Instead, communicate what the image means within the context on the page. Adding alt text to the images on your WordPress website is easier than you may think. You can add this text in the same place you'd add an image's caption. Open up your media library and select the image you want to edit. The settings screen for that image will open up. In the alternative text field, add your alt text, then click save. Poor color contrast can affect the readability of your sites in numerous cases, such as for users with poor vision, colorblind users, or people using certain devices. Images, text, and elements like buttons all need proper color contrast. Color contrast refers to how bright or dark colors appear when placed against or very near each other. The simplest way to determine whether your colors work well together is to insert them into a contrast testing tool like the Web Aim Contrast Checker. There are tons of free checker tools online. Keep in mind, if a color is difficult for a user to see for some reason, it could be impossible for them to differentiate between a linked word and a non-linked word. Use color to embellish a link, but add an underline below the text to make the link accessible. There are two main ways to discuss text when talking about accessibility: fonts and sizes. An accessible font is easy to read at small and large sizes. Fonts like Tahoma, Calibri, Helvetica, Arial, Verdana, Times New Roman, Arvo, Museo, Slab, and Rockwell are all accessible choices. Readers with dyslexia may find it challenging to read certain fonts, including many serif fonts. Sans serif fonts for body text tend to be a safer choice. It's best to avoid display fonts, like handwriting styles or cursive, unless the text is large, sparse, and mostly decorative. Font sizing is incredibly important to accessibility. Default fonts should be at least 9 points or 12 pixels. However, 12 points or 16 pixels is recommended. Utilizing varying font weights is just fine, but make sure that if your text uses the light weight, that it's large enough to see. This is not the end-all be-all of how to design with accessibility in mind, but it's vital to know where to start. Users should be able to interact with and use your website with relative ease, no matter what. This doesn't just include enjoying images and reading text, but interacting with menus, forms, buttons, and videos. When building your site, make sure that all interactive elements can be identified easily. All navigation menus, from header to footer, should be usable with keyboard controls. The appearance of links and buttons on hover, focus, and click should change. Navigation across the pages of your site should be consistent and clear. How you name, style, and position navigation links are incredibly important. Thoughtful breadcrumbs and clear headings will allow users to interact with your content confidently. Chances are you have a form or two on your website. You might be surprised to find out how many forms are inaccessible. Your form elements must include associated labels, either to the left or above the field. Checkboxes and radio boxes can go on the right. It should be crystal clear to users what each form field is for. If you have any content on your site that plays automatically, like a GIF, slider, carousel, video, or music, there should be visible controls that allow the user to stop the animation or sound. It's best to provide options to stop, pause, or hide the element altogether. WordPress themes control how your website looks. Many themes come prepackaged with color schemes and font families. It's imperative to make sure that those colors and fonts meet the requirements we have outlined. Many themes market themselves as fully accessible, but this isn't always true. Use your own testing to determine whether or not a theme is accessible. The accessibility team at WordPress.com has prepared a list of 92 free themes in the WordPress repository that you can start using right away. When building an accessible theme, ensure that you're familiar with the WCAG requirements from the very beginning. Common areas to be addressed during development include adequate color contrast within preset color palettes, the ability to navigate the website easily with a keyboard, using proper ARIA roles and/or HTML5 landmarks to ensure a screen reader-ready experience, proper HTML semantic markup, avoiding repeating IDs on a page, and allowing users to stop or control any auto motion. WordPress plugins allow you to add plug-and-play functionality to your WordPress site. There are two types of WordPress accessibility plugins: those that help you build an accessible website and make an existing site accessible for users. Be aware of WordPress plugins that provide you with guarantees like one-click accessibility or automatically accessible. These things are impossible. Plugins are tools that can help you achieve your accessibility goals, not magic wands that do all the work for you. Sometimes plugins can even hinder your accessibility efforts, so proceed with a degree of caution. There are tons of accessibility-focused plugins out there that promise to improve, monitor, or remediate accessibility issues. They might audit the site and let you know where to make improvements, or they may provide front-end tools to make creating an accessible experience on your site easier. Some of these are very helpful. Others, however, provide false promises. Always make sure to thoroughly vet a plugin like this before committing to it. Some plugins create interactive content like quizzes and sliders. As discussed earlier, these elements need special attention and testing to ensure that they're fully accessible. Always thoroughly test an interactive plugin on a staging or development site prior to pushing it live. The same can be said for form plugins. Unfortunately, many have accessibility issues. If you find this the case, custom-coded forms are a good alternative. A popular category of plugins is page builder plugins. These are great for allowing you to build robust and sophisticated drag-and-drop designs quickly. However, they can often introduce more accessibility problems than they can solve. There isn't a single fix to this problem, so keep your design simple and make sure you test all elements to confirm accessibility. An accessibility statement is a page on your website where you communicate your internal policies, accessibility goals, and past successes regarding working with people who have disabilities. You should generate and publish an accessibility statement on your WordPress website for the following reasons: to show your users that you care about accessibility and them, to provide information about the accessibility of your content, to demonstrate commitment to accessibility and social responsibility. Accessibility isn't about pressing the right buttons, then walking away. Testing is a vital part of ensuring that a site is fully accessible. Both automated and manual tests can help make sure you have all your bases covered. Automated tests are helpful to gauge where to start. If you're new to accessibility or are uncertain where to begin, start with automatic tests and evaluations. Most automated tests will identify things like poor color contrast, missing alternative text, empty links, problems with structural elements, and so on. You can use these tests to generate a list of problems to tackle. Tests like these are especially helpful for finding code-based errors that may be less visible to the naked eye, but will matter significantly to some of your users. One example of a free accessibility test you can use is the WebAIM tool. It examines your entire web page and generates a list of errors. It will even show you exactly where on the page those errors occur. You can find tons of individual accessibility tools to help with specific issues. For example, use a contrast checker before you even begin designing to make sure that the colors in your palette will play nicely together. Just remember that no automated test is perfect, foolproof, or a substitute for manual testing. Because WordPress accessibility is about real human use cases, real humans must be the ones to make the final say about whether a site is accessible or not. Consequently, reserving time and resources for manual testing is incredibly important. So, how do you perform a manual test? Here are a few things you can do to test how accessible a site is without fancy or expensive tools or programs. Ditch the mouse. Make sure that you can reasonably and easily navigate all of your website's functions using only your keyboard keys. This includes moving between sections, accessing menus, going from page to page, skipping down the page, and interacting with links and forms. Use a screen reader. Put yourself in the shoes of someone who has low or poor visibility. Use a screen reader app or website and review the content on your site to ensure it still makes sense and sounds smooth when read aloud. Test the site in different environments. Go somewhere with public Wi-Fi to make sure that your site loads properly without a high-quality internet connection. Take note of the areas of the site that lag or disappear altogether with a poor connection. Increase the zoom. Open up your site in a browser and use the browser settings to zoom in 200%. Can you still use, navigate, and engage with the site in this setting? Is there content that disappears or gets cut off? Focus on interactivity. Make sure to spend plenty of time testing interactive elements like videos, forms, and buttons. Links and form fields should always be brought into focus with an outline, underline, special cursor. Double check your alternative tags. If you're unsure whether or not an image has an attached alternative image, use the Inspect Element tool to confirm. Think differently. If all the images on your site disappeared, would someone still be able to use it? If all the colors on your site suddenly turned black and white, how would that affect usability? Make sure that the essential parts of your site still work if the decorative elements are somehow affected. Do you have any questions left about WordPress accessibility? Let us know in the comment section. If you're looking to boost your site's organic traffic and beat out your competition, then we have the perfect ebook for you. Download our free Ultimate Guide to SEO ebook to gain access to the 50+ tips we used to grow our own organic traffic by more than 123% year over year. Thank you so much for watching. If you found this video helpful, please don't forget to like, subscribe, and hit the notification bell for more tutorials, explainers, and helpful content like this.